Hey folks, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to a very important video, which is about how to analyze option chain. So if you have been following my Thursday live streams, which I take every Thursday at 9 PM, then you might be aware that I do talk about what could be the possible support or resistance levels for Nifty. Now, many a times the viewers tell me that Rachana, you have not discussed in any of your YouTube video as to how to interpret and analyze the option chain, and your wish or your command is definitely going to be honored. And that is why in this video, I'm not only going to talk about the various components that appear in the option chain, I'm also going to tell you how can you use these components to identify the probable supports and resistances, either for any stock or for the indices. Now let's start with the basic terminologies in an option chain. So whenever I try to read an option chain, you will see that the screen contains two major components, which is a call side and put side. So remember that any option has two types, one is a call option and one is a put option. So now let's start with calls. If I'm talking about call option or calls in general, there are always two parties to the contract. There have to be two parties to the contract, right? One is a call buyer and one is a call seller. Always remember, call buyer is bullish about the market and call seller is going to be bearish about the market. Because there are two contradictory views, that is the reason why a trade is going to take place, right? Also remember one point, that if I'm talking about a call buyer, he has a right to buy, and if I'm talking about a call seller, he has an obligation to sell, okay? If this was too much for you and if you did not understand this very well, don't forget to check out this video wherein I've talked about call options in detail. Right? Moving on to the next one, which is put options. Again, as usual, put option will also have two parties. One is a put buyer, one is a put seller. Focus. Put buyer is bearish and put seller is bullish. Here, it's a little bit different, exactly ulta, right? The put buyer, he is bearish, and put buyer always has a right to sell. And a put seller is going to have an obligation to buy. And again, if you have not understood what is this all about, then again, I have a separate video on what is put option and much more details about that. So don't forget to check out these videos. If you don't know the basics of call and put, if you are aware about all these things, then continue the video. Now let's try and understand what is an option chain and how to look up for it. So I'm on Google and I've just typed NSC option chain. This is the first search result that you can see, and I'll just click on that. And once you click here, you will see this big, oh, it's on and on and on. Okay, fair enough. Now, why do we call this as an option chain? If you remember, in futures and option, in specifically options, I said there are two types of options. Which two types? Calls and puts. So here you can see, here is something like calls. Here you can see something like puts. Okay, this is for what? This is for Nifty. But could it be for some specific symbol also? So just as an example, let us say I'm talking about IndusInd Bank. Okay, so here again, you will be able to see that, okay, for IndusInd Bank, here again, the big data is available. And again, for both calls as well as for puts, right? But then why is it called? Okay, we understood it's an IndusInd ka option. And IndusInd ka option, maybe we have call option as well as put option. But then why option chain? So for that, if you just have a look at this middle column, you can see that strike price is available for multiple strikes starting from 620, 640, 660, right up to 1260. So basically, both calls as well as puts you can get for multiple strike prices, and all these multiple strike prices are chained together, and that is why the name option chain. Moving on to one more important content of the option chain, that is known as the expiry date. Now, moving ahead with the same example of IndusInd Bank. Now, if I do a drop down here for expiry date, here you can see that there are only three expiries available. Which are these? 30th June 2022, 28th July 2022 and 25th August 2022. So typically these are the last Thursdays of every month. So you should not be confused that June ends on the 30th and that is why maybe it's 30th June as an expiry. But for July, then it would have been 31st July, right? But it's not 31st July, it's 28th July. So basically it's the last Thursday of every month as an expiry date. So you choose any symbol. I'm just choosing, let us say, indigo. And if I do that, again, you will see three expiries only. So for any stock, there are going to be only three expiries. But instead of a stock, if I take the example of an index, then for index, if you do a drop down, you can see multiple expiries. So always remember this. If I'm talking about a stock, you will see only 3 expiries, but for an index, you can see multiple expiries, number 1. Number 2, you should also be aware of the fact that if I'm talking about an index, then you will have a weekly expiry as well as a monthly expiry. But if I'm talking only about stock options, in that case, you will have only and only monthly expiries. Well, I want your maximum attention for the next 2 minutes because I am going to tell you an important concept not only of strike price, but I am also going to tell you what is the meaning of premium. Okay. Now, to explain this, I am going to take an example of Mr. A and Mr. B. Everyone knows my drawing skills. This is the maximum possible thing, right? Now, Mr. A, who is a buyer, and Mr. B, who is a seller, let's take an example of Chalo ABC Limited. This is the name of the stock. And the LTP of this stock is assumed 940. Now, Mr. A believes that, okay, I feel that this stock might go up. And that is the reason why I want to buy a call option for ABC Limited. Okay. Now, Mr. A says that I want to buy this call option with a strike price of 900 rupees. Okay. Now, what do we mean by strike price of 900 rupees? In simple words, Mr. A is buying a right to buy the underlying asset, in our example, ABC Limited, at a price of 900 rupees. He has a right to buy at what? 900. So now tell me, if he is buying at 900 and if the latest traded price of ABC is 940, life is set for A. He is going to buy at 900, he is going to sell at 940, he is going to get 40 rupees profit basla basla. Okay, but is seller going to allow that? No. Now seller is saying that if I am allowing you to do this transaction, you need to incentivize me. You need to give me a reward for that. And how much is going to be the reward? Reward is going to be the difference between the last traded price of the underlying asset and the strike price. So 940 minus 40, 40 rupees is going to be the premium. Who is going to pay to whom? Call buyer is going to pay to the call seller. Who is going to get incentivized? Call seller is going to get incentivized. Okay. So last time, quick revision. What was the strike price? You have to answer. Fadafat. What was the strike price? 900. He wanted the right to buy at 900. What was the premium? 40. What was the LTP? 940. Jhala na ta ajun kay sangu? Done. Well, right now we understood that premium can be calculated very easily, right? It's nothing but the price of the underlying asset minus your strike price, correct? But does this happen in real life or is there a little bit of deviation for that? Let's again continue with our example. So here, let's take the strike price of say 800 rupees, okay? Now tell me, how did we calculate premium? Premium was price of the underlying asset 843 minus strike price, which is 800. So tell me, ideally the amount of premium for this strike price should have been what? Should have been 843 minus 800, that is 43 rupees. But if you see, for June expiry, the premium is not 43, but it is 59.75. Now the big question is that if it is not the same, then why could it be so? It could be because of volatility, that is nothing but vega. It could be because of time to expiry or theta and many, many more points. But if you want to know about more of these in detail, then you can surely go and check out my course on futures and options. But this was just some important points that we have discussed till now in the option chain. Abhi to party shuru hui hai, the main part, that with the help of all these points, how can we identify the support and resistance level is what we are going to check out in the next part of the video. Well, before moving ahead with the support and resistance levels, let me tell you a little bit more about IndusInd Bank. They have come up with a savings bank account, which can be like a one-stop solution for your day-to-day banking requirements. In fact, the account opening process is very easy. You just need your PAN card and Aadhaar card. You can get up to 4.5% per annum rate of interest on your saving account, and on your fixed deposit account, you can get up to 6.5% rate of interest for individuals, and for senior citizens, you can get up to 7% as well. Well, not only this, you can also get rewarded for shopping and utilities. And if you want to open an account with IndusInd Bank with your choice number, then don't forget to check out the link in the description box below. Well, now moving on to the most important part about identifying support and resistance levels. But for that, I hope you know the important concept of open interest. You don't know that? Chalo, okay, let me quickly explain that and then we'll move ahead. So open interest is nothing but the number of contracts, number of option contracts that have been created but not yet closed. For that, let me again give you a simple example. Assume that we have two parties, Mr. A, Mr. B. Mr. A is a call buyer, assume he is bullish, and Mr. B, who is the call seller. Okay, what has happened? He has bought the contract and he has sold the contract. So what has happened? The option has been created but not yet closed. And that is why we say that open interest is 1. Okay, now what happens few days later? Few days later, assume both parties want to square up the contract. Square up the contract means what? Now A wants to sell and B wants to buy. When I say contract will be squared off, it will mean that open interest, which was 1, now has gone down to 0. Fair enough, right? Now, if I were to do a different scenario, what can be a different scenario? Going back to our example, A was the call buyer, B was the call seller. Now, few days later, A wants to square off, A wants to sell, but B doesn't want to buy. Now, A says, let me find another party. Who is that another party? Assume it is Mr. C. Now, what will happen? Again, understand. A will be the seller and B will be the buyer. So, now A's contract has been squared off. His position has been taken by Mr. C. And that is the reason why open interest has still remained 1, because C's contract is open and B's contract is also open. That's where we say open interest is still 1. Always remember one more thumb rule. High OI indicates high liquidity and vice versa. I know, I've made you wait for a long time. So without any further ado, let's now jump into the option chain analysis of Nifty. Well, this option chain is on the date of shoot, on the date of release, the option chain might look different, okay? Now, first things first, I need to understand that at what level are people most interested, okay? Hindi mein we'll say, bheed kahan pe ja rahi hai, right? So here, if you see, I have to focus on this data point of open interest. That is where people are entering into contracts and they are not yet closing it, right? But OI is as on date. Till date, what is the position? We also need to check change in OI. Change in OI happens on a particular date. Okay, so today, where is the highest change in OI? As I shoot the video, if you just scroll through this entire column, you'll see that today the highest change in OI has happened at the level of 15,800. This is the level where people are focusing the most. Okay, now we are on which side? We are on to the call side. Okay, so in simple words, on the call side at 15,800 level, call buyers as well as call sellers are buzzing a lot. Okay, but now we have to understand that call buyers are bullish and call sellers are bearish. So at 15,800 people, there are few people who believe that market will go up from here. There are few people who believe that market will go down from here. Big question is that whose view do we give more importance to? And if I were to choose this, I have to combine the OI analysis with the LTP analysis, the change analysis. What has happened to the LTP? LTP was what? Premium. Whether premium has gone up, this will be reflected in the change column, okay? Whether premium has gone up or whether it has gone down. Now, you only tell me. If the premium has gone up with increased OI, whose thought process is going correct? It is the call buyers whose thought process is going correct. Because assume that they had bought it at, let us say, 200 rupees. And right now, it is at 216 rupees. Who is going to be happy? Call buyers are going to be happy. Okay, so in this case, I will be giving more weightage to whose view? To call buyer's view. Okay, but please understand, had it been a reverse position, that if premium would have fallen down, who becomes happy if premiums fall down? It will be the call sellers who are happy if premium erodes, right? In that case, we would have given more preference to the call seller's viewpoint. Okay, so let's quickly understand what is the scenario as I shoot the video. 15,800, this is where highest number of people are interested, highest change in OI happens here. And what has happened to the premium? Premium has gone up. So now you only tell me, change in OI highest at 15,800, premiums have gone up. Whose viewpoint am I going to give more importance to? It is going to be the call buyer. And that is where I conclude that at this level of 15,800, I believe that there is a strong support. Okay. Why? Because I'm giving the importance to call buyers position, right? So this is for what? This is for call side. Now let us shift our focus to put side. Now you want to tell me, bheed kahan pe hai? Where are maximum people interested at? Here you can see change in OI. Today's position I'm talking about. Change in OI is happening at 15,500. This is how many open interest. Change in open interest is at 1729. Okay. And final OI you can see is at 10,114. Okay. Fair enough. Now again, same point. If I'm talking about put side, there are going to be put buyers as well as put sellers. Fatafat. Put buyers are what? Bearish. Put sellers are what? Bullish. Whose thought process will I give more importance to? For that, I have to again understand what has happened to the price movement. Price movement, LTP, the premium has gone down. Who is going to be happy if the price goes down? It's always going to be the sellers who are going to be happy if the premium goes down, right? And if I'm talking about a put seller is what? Put seller is bullish. And that is the reason why I can say that at 15,500, though, there is much, much stronger support. Correct? Had this been a reverse scenario, if the premium would have gone up, I would have given more preference to the view of a put buyer. And in that case, my conclusion would have been different. All in all, to sum up this entire discussion, I hope you have understood that as on the shoot date, I believe that 15,800 is a strong support. And also one more stronger support is seen at 15,500 level. Can these support and resistance levels change? Yes. Can they change every day also? Yes. Option chain analysis is a real-time data which gets updated. So please keep on checking this every single day for a better understanding. Well, I'm sure that any Thursday live stream from today, whenever I talk about option chain, whenever I talk about support and resistance, you'll be like, Rachana, we were able to identify the support and resistance level even before you talked about that. And I'll be the happiest person on earth if you are yourself empowered to understand the support and resistance based on option chain. But if you want to learn more about calls, you can click here. And if you want to know more about put options, you can click here. Till then, take care. Jai Hind and bye-bye.